All right, thanks, Ron. Many experiments have been done in the field of biotechnology of late. Scientists have developed insect-resistant eggplant and corn, which raise the potential for crop production without the risk to human health of health or the environment. Now, here to tell us more about these recent studies is Cornell professor Peter Davies. He is a plant scientist and a U.S. Department of State science fellow. Good morning, professor.
Good morning, Paolo.
This is a very interesting field. And I guess we should start with the very basics. I mean, what is this field really all about?
Okay, this field of crop biotechnology mm-hmm. is to improve crop yields mm-hmm. and also get crops disease resistant
okay.
and insect resistant so they can be produced with less toxic chemical pesticides. Mm-hmm. And this is, I think, going to be very important for the Philippines mm-hmm. To enable the farmers to produce the food that is needed
right.
without toxic exposure to the farmers or the general public.
Okay, how exactly is this done?
This is, we need to start off with the fact that the characteristics of all organisms are determined by a compound called DNA in their cells.
Mm-hmm.
And this codes their characteristics. But over the past 30 years, we have discovered how to modify this DNA
mm-hmm.
and to bring in characteristics from other organisms, but it's still just DNA
okay.
because all organisms are controlled by the same DNA.
Mm-hmm.
And it's rather like a chef having a cookbook.
Right.
If you have a good cookbook, it doesn't matter which chef does it, you produce the same result.
Okay.
So if you can identify a characteristic that you want in another organism, it's possible to move it mm-hmm. into a crop to get what you want. And this is done very precisely. Another important thing is some people say this is new. Humans have been doing this randomly.
Mm-hmm.
for thousands of years.
Right.
This has produced all our crop varieties.
Mm-hmm.
But what we can do now is rather than doing this at random, we can do it very precisely.
Very precisely.
So we know exactly what we're doing.
Okay, when we talk about, obviously what we're trying to get here is the most benefit from it. What are the real benefits that you see?
Well, there is, first of all, benefits to the farmers.
Mm-hmm.
Because at the moment, farmers can sustain big losses because of insect damage
right.
or disease. And this causes two things, a decrease in yield
mm-hmm.
and also a decrease in quality.
Right.
If you grow eggplant or talong
mm-hmm.
without insecticides, they're often very small, shriveled. I've seen them in the countryside
mm-hmm,
in the
mm-hmm.
Philippines. So they're heavily treated with insecticide.
Right.
So this enables you to get, if the new technology enables you to get nice fruit of talong
mm-hmm.
without spraying insecticide. So the farmers have a higher yield,
mm-hmm.
better quality fruit,
mm-hmm.
more income for the farmers,
right.
less pesticide use,
mm-hmm.
so the farmers or their children are not exposed to toxic pesticides. But if you go to the market now in the Philippines
mm-hmm.
and you see beautiful talong, they have been treated 20 or more times with insecticide.
Mm-hmm.
So the consumer does not realize they are ingesting rather dangerous pesticide.
Mm-hmm.
This new technology enables the production of talong without insecticide.
Yeah,
so for the consumer, it's much safer, so they're not going to be exposed to toxic chemicals.
All right. What specific plants and vegetables are sort of being experimented with?
The insect-resistant corn using this technology
mm-hmm.
has now been around for 16 years
mm-hmm.
and is used throughout the world.
Mm-hmm.
And a high proportion of world production of maize
mm-hmm.
has this characteristic. It is relatively new to have insect-resistant talong.
Mm-hmm.
And what is important is this has been developed by Filipino scientists.
Right.
And this, the Philippines is a leader in this technology. Mm-hmm. This is not developed by a commercial company. So there's not going to be any company making a lot of profit.
Right.
This is by Filipino scientists for Filipinos, and not only that, for the rest of the world.
Right.
So it is an amazing achievement by your own scientists here.
Okay.
And this is something we need to celebrate.
Okay. To balance that out, there are people who feel uncomfortable with the idea of genetically modifying plants and vegetables. Where do you think the discomfort comes from, and what is your reaction to that?
Well, yes, I acknowledge that there is opposition to this.
Mm-hmm.
And this opposition is largely based on two things: lack of understanding of the science mm-hmm. by the public,
mm-hmm.
and for some reason various organizations are opposed to this for no scientific reason, no valid mm-hmm. scientific reason. And because they have many websites that promulgate this pseudoscience or this fear, a lot of people who don't know what this technology is mm-hmm. become afraid. All you have to do is to tell the public that they are being poisoned
mm-hmm.
with no, this is not the case. But if I tell you, you are being poisoned, you immediately become very concerned.
Mm-hmm.
So that is basically what is happening. But the vast majority of scientists, sort of 95-99% in the world, who understand genetics mm-hmm. and molecular biology and biotechnology, support this process
mm-hmm.
because it is much more precise. We know exactly what has been done. We know the characteristic that has been transformed. And I should point out, this is a technique. Biotechnology is a technique. It's mm-hmm. not a product.
Right.
What you do with biotechnology is the most important thing.
Okay.
And so we can use this to good or ill. And by using it for good, we are benefiting everybody in the world.
Mm-hmm.
So I think what I'm trying to do is to get out to the public that this is a beneficial technology.
Mm-hmm.
It is perfectly, well, it is as safe as non-biotech crops.
Mm-hmm.
And the people who don't like this try and scare the public,
mm-hmm.
and they claim that it has caused death, illness, or allergy. But there is not in the whole world a single proven case of even illness or allergy due mm-hmm. to these crops. By contrast, even organic farming can cause problems because you can have contamination by bacteria mm-hmm. in organic produce. And every year there are numerous reports of people getting sick
mm-hmm.
from organic produce. Just 2 weeks ago, my wife became very sick
mm-hmm.
from eating organic produce, and the next day there was a recall on this product that she had in front of her.
Right.
So you don't get that with biotech crops. They are a wonderful boon if only people understand that this is a perfectly safe process
okay.
and is a wonderful contribution, as I said.
Okay, well, like you said, it's proudly Filipino.
The BT Talong is Filipino,
okay.
Absolutely.
Well, yeah,
and there's another one being produced here in the Philippines, golden rice,
mm-hmm.
which has improved nutrient characteristics,
mm-hmm.
and that is being perfected down at the International Rice Research Institute.
At Erie.
Another one in the public domain, produced by or perfected by Filipino scientists.
Okay, this is a very interesting field. I think if people are interested to learn more, make their own decisions, they can certainly look it up. All the information is out there. Thank you so much for starting this great discussion. I think people will be more interested now to look into it. And thank you for giving us your side of
things. Okay, well, thank you.
Thank you so much, Doug.
Okay, thanks very much.
All right, let's go back to Warren now. He's at the Ayala.